Hey there and welcome! Today we are talking about how to introduce a new character to your ongoing campaign. There are some games that will benefit from it more than others. Perhaps it's just a campaign way or a campaign style, but perhaps it is based on your game or your system. Because there are some games, like some OSR based games, where they base already the idea that you have a lot more character deaths. And if that happens, you need to introduce new characters more often. But there are also some kind of campaign styles that benefit from this idea of introducing a lot of players or a lot of characters frequently. Some of them are like bounty hunters, squadrons, heights, and so on, or even West Marchers and West Marchers adjacent games. However, for people in a long-lasting campaign, it might be a bit more difficult to justify an in-game the bringing of a new person to their already tight group. Sometimes the need comes because one of the players had to take an hiatus, like I mentioned in another video. Sometimes it is just that someone is excited and wants to try the game or the system. Whatever the reason, it is always easier if it is planned in advance. So communication is always the key and it will help a lot. Both the players and the GM trying to bring this new player to the table. So the players already in the table and the new player. If the GM is always aware of that in advance, that someone will start the game, it makes it easier to come up with a solid way to do so. Bear in mind that this in-game justification is not something that it's written in stone or that needs to be fulfilled in order to game to continue. But it's something to bear in mind. It can just as well be as a retcon if everyone at the table is on board with that, and then just introduce them supposing that they were already in the story from before. But it's something that then needs the group together to justify. But if you are trying to make it without the use of this resource, I believe that there are mainly two approaches that are better to, in order to not introduce this kind of retcon unnecessarily. They can be further subdivided, but so is life. So the first one of them is what I call a pseudo-NPC. That is perhaps more useful when someone is trying to temporarily test the system or the game. And as the name suggests, this pseudo-NPC is a character that is already an NPC or that will be an NPC later on, in case that the player leaves the game. It can happen. A positive aspect of this approach is that it removes the burden on the player to have to come up with the character from zero. But actually, who said that it's a burden, right? We all have a lot of character concepts in our mind. It depends. So, which leads to one of the drawbacks of this strategy. Because with this strategy, you remove a little bit of freedom from the player to create the character. So they can end up losing a little bit of character in their character, if you know what I mean. Because even if the plan is to have the character to become an NPC later on, some decisions about background and such might be restricted, even if it was not already an NPC established, but it will be only in the future. I'm not very fond of this approach, particularly. I'm not saying that someone that likes that it's wrong, but it's something that is much more restrictive than choosing from, even than choosing from a list of pre-gens. With pre-gens, like I mentioned in another video about one-shots, usually it is done in the way that you have some ideas for the character in a one-shot or something similar. But they are not fully fleshed out, so they have a basic kind of backstory and you can just fill it on. Although there is always the possibility for the character to, actually for the player, to change from a character that best fits their needs or their wishes. But then we found the second one, even if it's done later on. And this second one is the player from scratch. And This is the classic way. This way, the player has full creative freedom, apart from the things agreed in their kind of session zero. I mentioned how session zero is important, but someone coming later in the game, they won't have the session zero per se, but you know what I mean. The downside is that it brings more work for both the player and the GM, because they need to come up with their character in a way to make it fit into the plot. However, I believe that for both options, in case that the GM and the player they do not work in tandem, it will make something much more difficult if they don't work in a way to make it fitting to the particular point of the campaign or of the story. It can actually break the immersion. That is something that we always keep in mind. So it's true that it can be limiting if time is a factor, mainly, because like bringing someone to a hot swap in a game without the person being able to prepare at all. But however, I still believe that it is also bad to bring someone without preparation in the other option, the first one, in the pseudo NPC. So this puts much more freedom for both player and GM when creating the character in the second option, but also puts much more responsibility in them, because either way, they will have to properly set the moment and to have this character introduction to make it important. And as I talked earlier, for the players, they have already a group. So it is important to highlight that how they do not act particularly in a confrontational way, because characters that are already in a group, in a very tight and formed group, they can sometimes act confrontational. And so I'm talking to the players that are already in this group, do not act particularly difficult in order to not accept this new character. I reckon that it's something that a bit of time, it's normal to get used to someone before getting to be best buddies, but it can happen between the characters either way. But a bit of trust, at least in the beginning, is needed, since everyone wants the game to move on. There is always some situations that work just as well to put a group together in the beginning of a session or a campaign and when introducing a new character. And the common goals or the mutual help can always be something that can work. But bear in mind, if you are the GM, to not force the players in this situation. Like, for instance, do not purposely make them lose or start losing a battle or something, or being captured and removing their player agency, because removing player agency is not okay in any way. So even if your ideas might be positive, it's not a good approach and it's not something that will be healthy to the continuing of your game. So to recap, for the GMs, you can either use a pseudo NPC or a PC from scratch. They have their pros and cons and they are particular, but either way, do not force players into situations that they are not comfortable with. And still, the best thing is to communicate. For players that are already in the game, take it easy. Like, this is my character, or this is what my character would do, rarely sounds positive and rarely brings the game forward. A bit of trust is always welcome. And communicate as well. And for the players that they are coming with and that they are getting into an ongoing campaign, do your homework. Like, study in a way that, talk with the game manager how the game is going, how it is progressing, what is the world, how is the story, what your character is already aware of, and then be ready when the session starts. And try to have fun, because perhaps it's your first game and you are trying to discover it, so try to have fun. Even if you are coming in the middle of a new game or of a new campaign with some kind of well-established group. Apart from that, I believe that that's it. If you like the video, like the damn video, share, subscribe, you know how internet works, it's everything down here, and let me know in the comments how you introduce new players, how you introduce new characters, how you already done it, if you were the new character in an unknown campaign, how it worked, how it was best for you, how even if I am wrong, correct me, I do not have a problem with that, and we can discuss. And I'll see you all in the next video. So, see ya!